time I say Frank, I... Ooh, hold on. First blood coming out from DM over bottom. MJZ dropping. And then back over towards top. They're putting some pressure on Nightfall. He'll jump back over to the Witch Doctor. I feel like it's all tensing up, ready to go in just a second. They've spotted the Undying again, and they're going to run over. GPK coming in with the Mars. God's Rebuke, I think that missed. And they're going to look to finish him off. They land the Spear. Not looking like that God's Rebuke miss is going to matter. And Save will get the kill on MJZ.
Yeah, pretty uneventful game still. Everyone just farming away. Ooh, good kill.
Another kill.
Which means top tower is under a lot of pressure.
Windranger going in for this, and trying to get a kill onto Kingslayer, finishes him off. Bullseye now on the run.
Yeah, Exorcism back online. They're running into the triangle.
Yeah, they're going to find the style, but they don't land the spear. Is he going to be able to stay alive? They've got the cask as well as the Maledict. They'll use the Supernova. They take out the egg. They're going to focus their attention onto the Witch Doctor first with the Mortimer's Kisses coming in. And well, they'll get the gun to Leostyle. They'll end up losing Kingslayer. Icarus dive away. And it's a one for one, a Witch Doctor for a Windrunner, which works out. DM.
Trying to steal an Ancient Stack. Okay, with a Tombstone. Should be pretty easy. Let's see if Beefy wants to contest
this. Now they're going to go after Frank. They'll use the ult. They've got the spear. They'll have the damage with the Maledict. They'll get the kill to Frank. And yeah, you're going to steal our stacks, or at least try to. And we're going to take out your Tide. That means no Ravage for at least 25 seconds. So maybe Virtus Pro thinking about making an aggressive play here with
they don't even know about it.
But Kingslayer's up. And he'll be the one who goes onto the high ground. He doesn't have much to give in terms of a fight, but the blink over with the spear that lands. Mortimer's Kiss is coming in. That's going to be onto GPK. They'll bring over DM, who pops
coming from
the
behind.
Exorcism, who's focusing over on Leostyle, gets killed off by the Cryptstorm coming out from DM, and now they've got the Son of the Death Prophet. He's all alone, 3v1, trying to survive. Spear pushing away the Undying. DM still surviving. They're going to go after this Weaver, and I don't know if he's going to be able to survive. Mino's trying to run. He's been silenced up. He's in the Shikuchi, the Cryptstorm the wrong way, and he just gets out of there. They'll use that Ravage. They've got the Supernova down. They get the kill on the DM, and now GPK, who's still alive in this engagement, blinks forward. God's Rebuke lands the Spear onto Moose and takes out this Snapfire.
And you can't bring him down. That's where all the damage from the Spirit Siphon comes in. Good arena,
arena
Spear.
They've got the Spear. Moose in trouble. Moose is gone. He moves no longer.
Yeah. And Weaver also with the Beatles. They're Focus Fire, Tombstone. Oh, but they know it. Dropping very quickly, though.
They're not going to be able to make a jump in. Minos gets the Aegis, and now they're going to go back.
Good check.
Oh, lands. Oh, wow. DM getting caught out. Not only do they get an Aegis, but they get a plus one on that.
But he will have to turn into a hero killer soon because PA will outscale the Weaver.
Oh, DM again. Getting caught, getting killed, and.
As his name implies.
Maybe even make something happen to. Try and get some
PA
teammates around
out.
Him, but left alone. Into the trees, Kingslayer meanwhile dead, and they'll use that Fire Snap Cookie. They've got the Gush, they'll get the kill. He already used the Icarus Dive, that means there's no way out. Another two kills there for Thunder Predator, the BKB. It's popped.
Nice BKB reaction there.
Leostyle is trying to get some damage in on a GPK. This BKB is about to run out in a second, but does GPK really want to turn on this? It's not looking likely.
Good Ravage.
The Ravage, that's going to land onto the Death Prophet as well.
Check out.
Now they're going to look over to get even more. The Shackle lands on a bolt. They get the kill to GPK as well. DM.
And we have yet to see PA do anything this game. Sitting at 0-0-0. Yep. Probably at around 3,000 hero damage. And not an
no
easy
surprise,
kill.
Another Shackle. Yeah, and that's going to lead to an easy kill on Kingslayer. He is...
Alright, whatever. I think I'm done with you for now. Focus on the game instead.
They
oh,
got
no!
the arena, but the spear is going to send him through it. They've got the Tombstone onto the high ground. That's going to give them vision in this fight. They're going to move forward looking for something that go their way. And it goes really quickly their way as they get a kill on a Kingslayer who has continued to die in this game. He spent no time playing Dota and a lot of time in the grave. And, well, honestly, I think they're looking to put the finishing touches on this game. I think they're real close to really cleaning this one up.
Look at the damage!
Once again. Shackle Shot coming through, Fire Snap Cookie, that lands. Power Shot from Leo Stylin.
You jump in on a support, and they just turn around and slap you.
Arena comes through, pulls the spear. That's going to be out of Frank, but he's so tanky. I don't know if they're going to be able to get through on this. They've got the cast.
Ravage
there's
on three.
The Malekith goes through onto the Tidehunter. They've got the Ravage on three of these heroes as the Weaver's going to be on the Magpies. Looking over at the Witch Doctor, they get the kill on the Kingslayer, which is something that I've repeated quite a handful of times. Power Shot comes in. That's going to get a little bit of vision onto the Mars. They'll continue to try and chase GPK. And they've got the Tombstone, so really deterring Virtus Pro from coming in and defending this tower. But I think at some point they're going to have to just go for it. Gucci forward, Kingslayer taking some damage to back off. They land the spear, but the Ravage from Frank is perfect. They're going to get the kill into the Kingslayer. They're going to look over with these Mortimer's Kisses. BKB's been popped by GPK, but is this to do anything? It's not looking likely. It's just to really back away. They do finally get a crit come through. They're going to end up getting the first kill onto this Weaver. Power Shot comes in.
Like, they're not 100% out of it. It's just going to be very, very difficult to win from this point on.
Yeah, the game winning
he's
is
running up by himself.
At this point. He's rocking onto the high ground, and all of a sudden, oh my god, that was really potentially a spot where he could have just died. They get the Shackle, that's going to connect onto the Death Prophet. They've got Kingslayer, who's putting out a pretty decent ult with the Supernova a little bit too far back. They get the kill on the DM, they're going to lose this Death Prophet, and now the Supernova ends up going off. So Virtus Pro really don't have anything to work with at this point. Now is a moment for Thunder Predator to move in. They land the Spear, but can they get the kill onto the Weaver? They'll take out Kingslayer once again. He doesn't have buyback. He's dead for 55 seconds with the BKB being used by Nightfall. Well, his options are limited as well. So with the options limited from Virtus Pro, oh, Shackle landing on a two, but no follow-up from Thunder Predator. It's going to be difficult for Virtus Pro to feel confident in taking a fight at this point. And Thunder Predator, I mean, they're playing with the thought of going in. BKB's been popped by GPK. That'll avoid the Fire Snap Cookie that was thrown from Moose onto the Tidehunter that lands onto the Mars. As Moose getting low, right click's coming in. That's going to be a crit coming in from Nightfall. That's going to get the cone of Moose, but they get the cone to save. They'll end up losing MJZ. That's 2 years gone on the side of Thunder to Predator. They'll buy back on the Undying. They've landed the spear onto the Weaver. They get the cone of Nightfall. And without the Phantom Assassin, it's not going to look likely that Virtus Pro can bring this one back. A full team wipe for Thunder Predator. And turn it the other way, right?
Tidehunter
here. Lands on
he's so tanky, he has Ravage up as well.
They've got the Arena, they're going to land the Ravage on the 2.
He didn't pop BKB,
Shackle again. Oh man, Nightfall, he falls, and it is looking dreadful for the side of Virtus Pro.
GG! It's over.
It is called.
Done. It's all over. Man. They're absolutely, they just took it right to their face. DP had no chance whatsoever.
Yeah, it's not terrible, but again, that's Shadow a beastmaster that's down trying here. To stir your tempo. Ooh. And yeah, Shadow Demon going down. Taking out MJZ and looking over Shadow Demon, he's gonna drop too. DM also taken out here. Troll getting a double kill.
Yeah, using his ult perfectly, getting that extra bit of attack speed he needs to really deal the damage to kill that Underlord. And it just shows again how strong of a laner Troll is.
Bottom lane just pushing a little bit where he can. Aether Remnant, that's going to lock up the puck. They've got the Fortune's End. Leo's style on the run, but the Purifying Flames with one more shot from GPK.
If you give this guy free farm, he is going to snowball. You have to be very well.
They found themselves the Oracle. They need to
certainly
make something
is, and now he's stealing the Envy's Triangle as well.
Yeah. They're doing everything right at the moment. The Astral Sight comes
strong.
Out on the Moose, but the Aether Remnant doesn't land. They've got the Fortune's End on a 2. They're getting the kill on the Moose. They'll look over now at the Troll. They'll land the Dreamcoat only on the Voyager. They use that Supernova. They get the kill on the Troll before he gets that ult off, and they're going to take out the Egg. Everybody here for the side of Virtus Pro, and that's the shutdown they need.
And they might be setting up with the Roar here. They can find it.
Dream Coil bottom.
Bottom Pocket Coil
to get this Monkey King. They've got the Geomagnetic.
Kick him
out. Break the coil. Magnetize on the Nightfall. They'll get themselves the false promise to keep him alive.
Unfortunate. The Puck Orb missed, like it just missed. Are they going in on the Earth Spirit?
Ooh,
here?
Good Aether Remnant.
Easy.
That was really well placed. They'll get the kill on the, but they've got the silence. They'll have the Primal Roar. They don't have a false promise to save him this time, but they do have a disruption coming in from Save. Yeah, he saved him. And they'll try to get GPK out with an Assimilator. Illusory Orb over, but it's not the right direction. So GPK hiding in the trees, staying alive for now.
Mm-hmm. Well, VP is definitely going to be feeling the pressure a little bit more than Thunder Predator right now. Oh, good setup on the troll, taking a lot of damage.
They've got some damage onto the troll. Can they get the first kill onto this troll? They'll lose the Aegis pretty quickly. The Dream Coil is going to be placed here onto the Shadow Team. They'll look to get the kill out on a save. They'll take him out for the first time. He does not have buyback to come back a second time. Just never felt comfortable fighting, and even at the end, fighting, getting what, one kill, it just was never really a big enough
boost going in deep.
PA, and that's a great roll. Not only does it break the smoke, but they've got the Jumang and a group as well as the Boulder Smash coming through onto the Oracle. They'll use that Supernova. It's going to push back the side of Virtus Pro, but they've got themselves the Promo World. They're going to stun up this Monkey King. They'll use these right clicks, but they've got the save coming in with the disruption from Save. So, can Virtus Pro turn it around? It's not looking likely with DM falling, but the Wukong's command comes out. They'll get the kill to the Oracle. Kingstar is going to be the second one to fall on the side of Virtus Pro. They'll lose a third in GPK. They'll go after Save. Shadow Demon low. Shadow Demon gone. Double kill here for Minos, and it is a 4-0 in the favor of Thunder Predator.
No land pressure, no land fear, nothing like that. He's doing it again.
And that's going to hit on the Oracle, and immediately he's going in under the side of Virtus Pro. They'll get the save with the disruption and the hook. Boundless strike onto two of these heroes with the Wukong's command coming out. They get the Kona Booze, and that's going to be the Supernova on the high ground. That's going to send Virtus Pro back. They don't want to fight into the egg, nor should they. Meanwhile, Leo Style, in the tree, silenced up, all by himself, gone.
Fruit Ninja? Mom, can I borrow your phone?
Yeah, I want to cut some fruits. They're going on to the troll here.
Troll. They're going to try and go after this troll. They've got the Aether Emanator as well as the Balance Strike. Do they have the damage to get the kill here on Amino?
Life
no, they don't. They've got the BKB as well as the Trance. The Disruption's going to save the Monkey King for a moment, but look at the damage coming out on the Kingstar. They're getting the kill to the Oracle, and they're going to look over as the Dream goes down on a two. They find themselves a kill on a save as well as DM. Three heroes down on the side of Virtus Pro with the Sunray on both the Void Spirit as well as the Monkey King. They get the kill on a Nightfall. GPK next
five
to fall,
five.
And he is gone. The whole team is dead on Virtus Pro. Nobody dead on the side of Thunder Predator.
I want to get out of here right away. Come in or don't. I don't care. Monkey King, he has been caught by Moose.
He finally found him, all the searching, finally gets there, and they're gonna use the Dream Coil. Yule's up into the air with the roll coming in. Moose trying to break these trees, so he has nowhere to go. That's a thousand IQ right there, so he can't jump away. The roll is gonna miss, and now
he's
going to the
Wukong's
man. No, he won't. Geomag Knight of Crit comes in, and that's gonna be the silence, as well as the Primal Roar. They get the kill on a Nightfall. That is so well done by Moose.
And look at Monkey King. He had Scotty queued up. Look what he has now in his quick buy. Now it's a BKB. He doesn't want to have that happen again. Absolutely outplayed. And now that Yule Scepter here, GPK in trouble.
Yeah, silence up with Waning Rift. They're going to get the False Promise off, so that might save him. But up in the air once again, he needs to find a way out. He's going to ask for step away, but I don't know if that's far enough out. Looking over now at Minos with BKB being popped by this troll. Not going to turn. They've used the Supernova, so a little bit used by the side of Thunder Predator, maybe giving it an opportunity for Virtus Pro to go in, and they really need to make something of this because they've used the buyback on Nightfall. They'll use the Wukong. Silence comes out, but it's going to be a little bit late. They've got the Peter Mouse. That's going to lock up the Phoenix. Is that going to be enough to get the kill there? At least one. Yes, it will be. MJZ ends up dead. Fuels up into the air.
Huge call of war.
They've got the Silence, but he's going to be able to survive. Lead the cheese, and now the Dream Flow comes out. That's going to snap out a couple of these.
Control that match.
Look at the kill on the GPK, and now they'll look over the rest. They get the kill on the Kingstar, and now GM, he is red and gone. Shadow Demon rolled on, Moose still in deep, and that is the Waning Rift silence, but they won't get the kill to the Shadow Demon with buyback being used by both this Underlord as well as the Oracle. God. Have Virtus Pro had, like, a solidified net worth? Again, Moose, stop. Geomagnetic Grip, Waning Rift, double silence. He's not getting away. The roll comes out from Moose once again. They've got the Yules up into the air. He's ready to get
bam,
a kill.
Bam, bam.
He'll be the one who gets the damage. He'll be the one who gets the kill.
The crit bash has taken off a quarter of his health. This troll is an absolute monster. Oh, I'm coming here on the Monkey King. There's no BKB yet.
False promise, though. He's saved. For now. Yeah.
Or is he maybe falsely saved? False promise, you know? It's a lie.
Geomagnetic Grip.
We'll have to see if he gets away.
We've got the Silence, Abyssal, and the Waning Rift. Another kill on a GPK. It really is just mounting, isn't it? It doesn't get, it's like, oh, you know, you've got Aegis, you've got Cheese, you've got a 43k lead. You could have double damage too, because we're slamming this door shut on you guys and throwing you out of the building. We've seen it a couple times, though, where he gets a little bit too far ahead of himself and he loses the Aegis pretty quickly. That stopped them from going up onto the high ground a couple of times already. So he needs to be careful, Munoz, about moving in too far, but they're going to go with the Primal Roar. That's going to be out of the Shadow Team. It moves going out of the backlines with the Geomagnetic Grip that hits out of the Monkey King. They've got the Silence out of three of these heroes, as well as the Dream Core up through on all three heroes. They get the kill on the save, and they're going to work for more. They've got the Kyle XP going in.
Control damage.
They've got themselves new kills. They don't have GBK for 93 seconds. He's not going to have buyback, and they're going to use themselves the Dark Rift to get away. Disruption coming through. They're trying to lock up this troll, but you got to remember that he's got two lives, and he's hard to kill. Fortune Zen comes out, and that's going to lock him up for a sec, but they just don't have the control to get a kill here on Aminos. Fortune Zen, Lincoln's pop, but he is healing up, going after the top set of Rax, as well as this tier 3, and BP have no answers. The Silence comes out for the three heroes once again with the Waning Grift, as well as the Illusory Orb Escape from Leo style. They'll start to go in on these Rax and look for Mega Greens. Balance Strike, Age is still there. Hit of Malice, it's on him with a Firestorm, but a pop the BKB. He'll go after the Rax, and now he'll use the Abyssal Blade to focus.
He's dying so fast, Monkey King!
They'll look to get the kill on a Nightfall, and they'll take out of the game 109
no
seconds. GGB gone.
Gaga!
Oh, GG! 2-1 over Virtus Pro, and they will take them out of the tournament. They will not.